Hello everyone! Today I would like to tell you about a metal which many of you dealt with in childhood when using nickel-cadmium batteries, which were in widespread use in the 90s. I think many of you had toys which ran on such batteries. It is time to learn more about the properties of such a metal as cadmium and why it was used to power remote control cars. In the periodic table of chemical elements, cadmium belongs to the group 12, placed right below zinc. This metal was discovered in Germany in the beginning of 19th century as an unknown substance which was contained in such a mineral as calamite. After that, this metal was mainly used in pigments and they were added to lots of paints used for painting cars, trams and other objects. Metallic cadmium was obtained from this mineral using a reduction method. Pure cadmium flakes don't look any different from those of magnesium, but as soon as I touch it with tweezers, the difference becomes clear. In contrast to magnesium, cadmium is a very soft metal and also very toxic. That is the reason why nickel-cadmium batteries have been substituted by nickel-metallohydride batteries. From a chemical point of view, cadmium is something between mercury and zinc. On air, cadmium quickly oxidizes, covering in a layer of gray cadmium oxide. If you try to melt it, the metal will start oxidizing even faster and also melting quite quickly because of the metal's low melting point. The cadmium oxide, obtained as a result of reaction with oxygen, is used as pigment for painting ceramics and for coating steel of special electrolytic tanks. It used to be used for manufacturing semiconductive films for early light-emitting diodes. If bits of cadmium are heated up with sulfur, such a reaction will produce cadmium sulfide, a very toxic chemical of yellow color. Cadmium sulfide used to be a very popular pigment among 19th century artists. That is why presence of this cadmium compound in dyes helps establish authenticity of paintings, for instance, such as Vincent van Gogh and Matisse paintings. Besides reacting with non-metals, cadmium also reacts well with acids, for instance, with nitric acid. This reaction runs highly actively, releasing a lot of nitrogen dioxide. However, cadmium reacts way less actively with sulfuric acid than with nitric acid, and dissolving takes much more time. Adding alkali to the test tube with the obtained solution, for instance sodium hydroxide, will produce a reaction with white cadmium hydroxide sediment, which by the way is also present in nickel-cadmium batteries. Looking at the design of nickel-cadmium batteries, we can say that it is not that complex. There is nickel basic oxide inside the case, which serves as a positive electrode, and oftentimes cadmium serves as a negative electrode, which can easily be rolled into a thin sheet because of being highly plastic. Separators are usually set between electrodes, and in the end, batteries are filled with potassium hydroxide electrolyte. The advantage of such batteries is their high discharge current, which actually doesn't run for a long time, when all the energy needs to be passed in a short period of time. In the 1990s and in the early 2000s, such batteries were most frequently used to power the every toys of our childhood. However, because of being costly and toxic to the environment, the nickel-cadmium batteries were substituted by less expensive and toxic nickel-metalhydride batteries, which were quite efficient. Nowadays, cadmium is mainly used in electronics manufacturing. For instance, cadmium telluride is used as a main material for manufacturing thin-film solar cells, which are much cheaper to manufacture than silicon ones. Moreover, cadmium selenide is used to produce nanoparticles, which are then used to manufacture QLED displays. In the nuclear industry, cadmium is used as a good neutron absorber in control rods inside nuclear reactors. However, it is important to remember that L-cadmium compounds are very toxic to people, and that stricter and stricter regulations are being applied to air pollution control and working environment during this metal's manufacturing. But even with that being the case, the global demand for cadmiums is increasing, which indicates that in spite of its toxicity, cadmium is still a very needed and important metal for science and manufacturing of electronics. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.